Good evening and good morning somewhere out there in the world. You're listening to Sound Off with E.V.E. here on WLTH Radio, AM 1370, the region's choice, the people's voice, and happy Tuesday. And for those of you that are out there driving, be safe because it looks like it wants to do something out there. The clouds are getting thicker and darker. Please pay attention to the weather. Please pay attention to the traffic and to your driving as well. It's Tuesday, guys. We apologize for not having a show yesterday. I'm sure Ms. Natalie had announced it. Didn't have a board up, so here I am. Happy Tuesday to you guys. But today may not be a very happy show today. I mean, yes, I'm going to bring the positive. Yes, I'm going to talk about solutions. But I'm going to talk about something that I have been feeling, seeing, breathing it, hearing it in every sense of the word media, in every channel, in every newspaper, in every Facebook, media, Twitter. It's called hate, crime, violence. Yeah, it may sound like a broken record, but today's about hate. How much? And see, I always tell my kids, hate is a very strong word, and it really is. And that's what I want to talk about today. But first, let's see if I know Omar's got a savvy, smart device there that he can pull up my weather real quick. Let's talk about that right now because it looks like it wants to do something out there. And, you know, we'd hate for it to, see, there's the word hate, right? Hate, wouldn't I like for it to catch you walking out there or running from one place to another? Because it really looks like it's going to do something out there. I don't know if it's going to storm, hail, rain, or what. So let's see what Omar has to say with our weather here today.
All right, well, currently right now it's 67 degrees right here in Gary. It's cloudy. Tomorrow we're going to have intermittent clouds with a high of 70 and a low of 54 degrees. Thursday is going to be partly sunny with a high of 75 and a low of 60. On Friday, we're going to have partly sunny skies with a high of 78 and a low of 62. Saturday is going to be partly sunny as well with a high of 82 and a low of 65. Sunday, partly sunny with a high of 84 and a low of 67. Then on Monday, mostly sunny with a high of 86 and a low of 75. And then Tuesday will be mostly cloudy next week with a high of 91 and a low of 72.
So it's going to get warmer, guys. So take advantage of this nice sleeping weather. And someone told me, I'm going to give a shout out to all those that are listening and tuning in on Ustream, Buenas Tardes. Going to say a shout out to all of those Cancerians, everyone that has had a birthday or is celebrating a birthday this week. Happy birthday to all of you. And to be honest with you, birthday should be every day because you are having one day added to your age. Or sometimes I'd say one less day of life. I know it sounds kind of odd, but it really is. Because let's just say that the plan for God to have you here is 70 years old, and you're 59, and then the next day you're 59 and one day old, and the next year, so it's one less year because we're counting down. And see, we don't know how long we're going to be here on Earth. Only the big guy upstairs knows how long we're going to be out here on this earth, but, you know, I won't say I can't wait to be in the other life because I know the other life may be better, peaceful, but we have to make it that way here on earth while we're here. We have to make the best of it here while we're here on earth, and that's what I keep telling everybody. I keep, you know, I'm going to talk to your heart today. I'm going to talk to your spirit and your soul. If you have one, I'm hoping you do. That's who I'm going to talk to today. You're listening to Sound Off with E.V.E. And, of course, this is the region's choice, the people's voice. The views expressed by the hosts and the callers of this show are not necessarily the views of WLTH Radio, management, owners, and sponsors. And, you know, we're going to talk about hate, right? And hate is a very strong word. I mean, I learned that through our religion, I mean, Catholicism. But, you know, hate is nothing to do with religion, but the phrase hate is a very strong word. The definition of it, of course, you should already know what it is, and certainly not positive. Certainly something that's not in me, but it's not about me, because everything I read is somebody getting hurt, somebody manipulating somebody, somebody intimidating somebody, somebody being vindictive to somebody, somebody just being what they shouldn't be, and that's hating. Hate or hatred is a deep and emotional extreme dislike. It can be directed against individuals, entities, objects, or ideas. Hatred is often associated with feelings. Now, we're going to talk about the psychoanalytical views about it first before we go to the neurological and biblical. Now, you can call in and sound off at any time, 219-885-1371. Now, earlier, we're talking about, may she rest in peace, is the flight attendant that was killed by her own family, her own child. She had a record already, the child. There were red flags there already. Yes, maybe the mom was hard worker. She was flight attendant, so, you know, there's a lot of work involved in not being home. Yes, she was getting divorced as well. And no one deserves to die. No one deserves for someone to kill them, let alone their child doing that. That's a lot of hate. But that's a lot of probably built up stuff inside that child. I think he's 15 or 17 years old. And it makes you think. And then I see a report over the weekend about Chicago. How many shootings? How many deaths in just a weekend? I won't say really, as in sounding shocked. I'm just saying, really? More hate, more hate, more hate, more hate. Because obviously crime isn't sweet. Crime isn't pretty. Crime isn't nice. Killing, shooting, stabbing. None of that is nice, is it? Well, before I really get into this deep subject of hate, and this is unlike me, but I'm talking to your heart, to your spirit, to your soul. And I'm praying those that are listening to me actually can hear what's coming through. It's not me. It's not about me. But one thing that caught my attention before I get into the hatred part, all right, there was a carjacker. I don't know if you saw this, Omar. Carjacker gets mobbed by passerbys and arrested on the scene. I was cracking up. Not in the sense of laughing, should I say, that it happened to the woman and her child. By all means, that was not nice. But listen, and I cannot play the audio because it's got some vulgar language, very strong foul language, and that's something that I just don't work that way.
Well, give us a summary of it.
Well, let me tell you. In San Diego, an alleged attempted car theft, that would-be thief, would-be, because they caught him before that happened, became swarmed by community members who put a stop to the crime in progress. According to the video uploader, Aaron Leaf, the man had attempted to steal the car while a woman and her children were still inside the vehicle. Now, there is a warning, so whoever plays that video, the contents of violent graphic content and strong language, all right? The pedestrian passerby took notice at the screaming and immediately swarmed around the vehicle. After scuffling the keys out of the man's hands, the crowd continued to drag the alleged thief into the parking lot, beating and wrestling him to the ground. As the violence escalates to a mob beatdown, the man is seen bleeding as he attempts to crawl away. Moments later, police arrived on the scene and wrestled the man into a signpost, arresting him on the scene. Women and the woman and children were checked out by EMT, seen shaken up, but no physical injuries. What do you think about that one? That's what I think. I applaud that they came in and took action. What have I been seeing lately? the crowd, taking action, yes, but what kind of action? Videotaping, being spectators, saying, ooh, ah, look, yeah, get her, get him, yeah, ooh, that's what I've seen. Like not too long ago when a big woman worked at McDonald's, I think, put a beat down on a woman, and her child is there kicking her, telling her to leave her mother alone, his mother alone. And then the 14-year-old killing somebody else, and the uncle brings the gun so he can shoot, and then they're videotaping and nobody's butting in. And then you got in Maryville, you got a patient in the hospital, and the son comes in and kills her. And we think, allegedly, killed the father before he came and killed his mother. What the heck is going on? Well, we know what's going on. There's a lot of hate in people's heart. First of all, do they even have a heart? Yeah, one that's beaten. That's all it's doing. But is there anything in there as far as feelings, as far as empathy, as far as love, as far as respect? No, capital N-O. No, there isn't. If they don't do it for their own life and they don't feel respect for their own life and they don't love themselves, they're not going to feel that about who they're creating the crime or who they're hurting or killing. So hate is very strong, isn't it? Okay, we'll take a caller. Go ahead, caller. You're on the air.
Hi, how are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
I'm blessed. You know, I'm listening to all these different stories. And like you were saying about hatred, you know what really seems to get me is that with all those situations, you know, who'd imagine that they would come out that bad? You know, I was talking to a friend of mine, and they were shocked to hear that this person got stabbed right there in the hospital room.
Hello? Exactly.
You know, at the hospital.
They would not have ever imagined or fathomed the thought that it would be their son.
And then if you think about it, remember we had this situation with school shootings.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody ever imagined that there would be a Columbine.
But you know what's worse? That those red signs and those school shootings have been there for a long time.
Right.
That's what's worse. It's like, let me put some blindfolds and blinders and keep walking in denial.
Well, if you heard the story on a certain TV show, news show, they talked to the black parents, the African-American parents of the young man that was killed in Columbine. And the boy had went to the principal and had told them that the young man that did the shooting had threatened him before it happened. And he was told by the administration that type of thing doesn't happen here.
Exactly.
You know, and I said to myself, well, you know, views expressed. Anyway, I was a caller. But I said to myself, if I had been those parents, even though I wouldn't have brought my son back, I would have sued the daylights out of that corporation.
I'm telling you.
Because you had warning.
You did.
You know, this boy came and told you what was going on. And then it also, I was watching the documentary because I was showing it to my children. And there was a case where there was a young man that survived the Columbine shooting. He had been nice to one of the gunmen that morning. You know, he had been real polite and everything to the gunman. So when the gunman came up on him, he looked up at him and said, "You gonna shoot me too?" And the gunman looked to see where the other gunman was and told him, "Go on, man, get out of here. Let him go." And I said to myself, now what if that boy had been mean to that gunman that morning?
That would have been the first one.
You know, but it all goes back to what I've been trying to tell people. Try to speak to everyone respectfully. Try to treat everyone, you know, with courteously. Because in this day and age,
you just don't know what'll set
anybody off. You don't know the state of mind.
Exactly.
You know, and a lot of people will not admit that they have a mental illness or challenge, because when you do, you get stigmatized. So you don't want to admit it because people stigmatize you and, you know, judge you in a manner that's not necessarily befitting.
And you know what? I was reading an article about all these shootings that were taking place in schools, and it was, and I have to find it because it needs to be repeated because it's so factual that the triggers, the red flags, the signs were there for over a year. What they were posting on social media, what they were writing as far as their essays, their papers, all of that showed red flags.
And the other thing that got me was one of the boys was on antidepressants.
Mm-hmm.
And they used to show that wonderful depression on TV. It was a commercial
for it. They caused suicidal attempts and all that other wonderful stuff, right?
And then it was Zoloft.
Mm-hmm.
And they took
mm-hmm.
him off. Well, he was on it, and he said it made him feel worse than what he was.
Mm-hmm.
And they took him off. And see, you can't just take
individuals
off like that cold turkey.
Yeah, you got to wean
them
off.
You've got to give them something else because mm-hmm. if not, their depression and everything will get worse. And if it gets worse, there's no telling what they'll do.
Exactly. Exactly.
So, but that's another issue we need to look at.
Most definitely.
We need to stop hiding behind.
Hello.
Stop.
Not
hiding behind, but
no.
Stop putting our heads in the sand when it comes to mental illness.
Thank you.
You know, we don't want to talk about it. It's taboo. But then when someone with it does something so outrageous,
mm-hmm.
then we want to say, oh, the signs were there. Well, if you knew the signs were there,
why did you do anything about it? Exactly.
You know, because
exactly.
you never know. It could be you or your loved one.
Hello.
And then you'll feel betrayed.
Exactly.
But you all have a
Thank
good night,
you.
And I appreciate your show. And
appreciate you.
Have
Thank
a good
you.
Day.
Thank you. You as well. Be blessed. Thank you for calling in. And that's exactly what we have to call out, the red flags. Hate. Where does it come from? Yes, it's okay to get upset. It's okay to get sad. It's okay to show all our emotions. But for how long should we have these emotions? Does anybody got a good answer out there? For how long must we stay angry? Does anyone have a good answer? For how long must we continue to despise somebody, even though that somebody may not even done anything to me or to you, just because they look good or did something that you didn't like or you wish it was you and it's not you? When? How long? People hate just because they want to be you. Really? People hate you because they wish it was them and not you. How about the killings and saying, you know what, I'm going to divorce you. Well, if I can't have you, somebody else can't either. So let me go shoot you like the parent out there in Griffith, the Catholic school. Right in the parking lot in the middle of kids. Anger. Hate. Now, the psychoanalysis, Sigmund Freud, defined hate as an ego state which wishes to destroy the source of its unhappiness. More recently, the Penguin Dictionary of Psychology defines hate as a deep, enduring, intense emotion expressing animosity, anger, and hostility towards a person, a group, or object. Because hatred is believed to be long-lasting, many psychologists consider it to be more of an attitude or disposition than a temporary emotional state. Now, what I tell people is, look, don't make permanent decisions on your emotional or temporary emotions. Because sometimes we let that rage get the best of us and forget. Wow, I could have enjoyed my day. Wow, I could have just said yes and, man, I would have enjoyed the rest of my day. No, what did I do? I locked myself up and became that victim, became that prisoner of the word hate, the feeling of hate, that temporary emotional state. Making a permanent decision. I made a permanent decision to kill somebody based on that emotional or temporary emotional state. Now, the neurological research. The neural correlates of hate has been investigated with an fMRI procedure. In this experiment, people had their brain scanned while viewing pictures of people they hated. The results showed increased activity in the middle frontal gyrus. Right, the right putamen, or I don't know if I'm saying it right, P-U-T-A-M-E-N, putamen, bilaterally in the premotor cortex in the frontal pole and bilaterally in the medial insular cortex of the human brain. Now, the ethnolinguistics of that, it's a little different, but we're talking about hate here. If you're just joining me, I want to thank you, and also for following me on Twitter at Official Eve G, or Eve Gomez, or, yeah, Eve G, right? Official Eve G. And also for viewing me on Ustream. Shout out to all of those that are listening from Arizona, Las Vegas, Phoenix, California, Texas, Mexico, out there in the suburbs, Hanover Park, Palatine, wherever you're looking and listening. I'm talking to your heart today, right? And I want, I'm nobody. You're wondering, well, who is she? I'm nobody, and I didn't die and made, or somebody didn't die and made me God. No, it's just the fact that this is enough, and a lot of people are saying enough is enough, but I'm talking to the heart today. How many killings take place each week, each weekend, in each state, in each city?
Too many.
Exactly. But we're letting our temporary emotional state decide to screw up our lives. We're going to get locked up because we hated somebody. Temporarily. Some people hate for a long time, but you know, when I say people hate, they're actually hurting themselves. Someone wants to hurt me, I just have to pray for them and God and bless them. Because I'm just saying, you know what? You think you're hurting me. You're not. You're hurting yourself. Now, the ethnolinguistics. James W. Underhill, in his Ethnolinguistics and Cultural Concepts, Truth, Love, Hate, and War Discussion, this is from 2012, discusses the origin and the metaphoric representations of hate in various languages. He stresses that love and hate are social and culturally constructed. For this reason, hate is historically situated, although it is fair to say that one single emotion exists in English. French, Hain, German, Hass. Hate varies in the forms in which it is manifested. A certain relationless hatred is expressed in the French expression as je la haine, which has no equivalent in English. While for English speaking, loving and hating invariably involve an object or a person and therefore a relationship with something or someone. Je la haine, literally, I have hate, precludes the idea of an emotion directed at a person. This is a form of frustration, apathy, and animosity which turns with the subject but establishes no relationship with the world other than an aimless desire for destruction. Underhill, following Philip Roger, also considers French forms of anti-Americanism as a specific form of cultural resentment. At the same time, he analyzes the hatred promoted by Reagan and his rhetoric directed against the evil empire. In addition, Underhill suggests it is worrying that foreign languages, French, German, Spanish, Czech, are uncritically assimilating forms of hatred exported by neoconservative discourse, which permit these languages via the translation of political journalism with the rhetoric of the, quote, war on terror and the promotion of, quote, security. Now, the bigger issue right now that lies in the word hate, but more so in the feeling and the action that follows the word and feeling hate, is the legal part. Yeah, baby. That's the one that everybody needs to start thinking. If I'm going to do this and I get caught, guess what? They're going to lock me up. They're going to give me 50 years or to life, or I'm never going to see my family, things like that. But before I get into that, we're going to go for some commercial breaks. Don't go anywhere, and we'll be right back after this.
It's the newest, hottest radio show on the airwaves, The Hatcher Empowerment Factor. The Hatcher Empowerment Factor, hosted by sisters and attorneys Reagan, Rachelle, and Renee Hatcher, discussing breaking news, local and national politics, the justice and injustice system, education, and much, much more. Listen live and call in every Sunday from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Brought to you in part by Stella Shampoos and Conditioners. The Hatcher Empowerment Factor, Sundays from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. on the Region's Choice and the People's Voice, WLTA.
Dave's Construction. You got a project to build or a problem that needs to be fixed? Have you been putting it off just because you don't want the hassle and expense of hiring a full-time contractor? Well, look no further. Dave's Construction, paving, and sealing will come to you with reasonable rates, free estimates, and years of experience in Northwest Indiana. You can trust Dave's Construction to get the job done. Large or small, licensed and bonded in the state of Indiana. Days Construction is the right choice for the right project. Come visit us at 855 Taft Street, Gary, Indiana, or call us at 219-944-1810. That's 219-944-1810. Days Construction.
Days Construction says, coming soon, the Dirtiest Jazz Blues House, located at 4601 Milton Road, Gary, Indiana. Days Construction puts his money back into the community.
This is a special message that I'd like to send to all of you, because there's so much hate, and just removing guns isn't the only issue that will solve things. It's not the only solution. It's one of to add to everything else. We need to all come together. We should not allow any more guns. Yeah, everybody has the right to bear arms. Yeah, okay. But our kids are grabbing them. Our kids are using them. Our kids are getting rid of themselves. Our kids are hating each other. Listen to this.
Some people just cannot react in time. Bullets do not choose a victim. It is the shooter that picks them. They just can't wait to get you in the system. The district attorney could use a conviction. Told you no guns and then you didn't listen. Life is so heavy with that on your soul. Dedicate this to Cheyenne and Josh and pour something out for the lives that they stole. 416.
I'm Bob.
Hi, I'm David.
And I'm Chauncey.
And we're the Heartfield Brothers. And you're listening to Eve Gomez on WLTH 1370.
All right, welcome back. This is Sound Off with E.V.E. And this is the Region's Choice, the People's Voice, AM 1370, WLTH. And the Sound Off number that you can call now is 219-885-1371. Tell me, am I just talking out of my neck? Or are you feeling this? Are you feeling my emotions? Are you feeling my heart, my feelings, or are you not feeling anything? Are you numb? Because usually when you're hating, you're numb. You have no feelings towards anybody or yourself. Now there's some legal issues to come behind that. In the English language, a hate crime, also known as the bias-motivated crime, generally refers to criminal acts which are seen to have motivated by hate. Those who commit hate crimes target victims because of their perceived membership in a certain social group, usually defined by race, gender, religion, sexual orientation, disability, class, ethnicity, nationality, age, gender identity, and political affiliation. Incidents may involve physical assault, destruction of property, bullying, harassment, verbal abuse, or insults, or offensive graffiti or letters, as in hate mail. I'm sure some of you probably either sent some or received some. Hate speech is speech perceived to disparage a person or group of people based on their social or ethnic group, such as race, sex, age, ethnicity, nationality, religion, sexual orientation, gender identity, disability, language ability, ideology, that's the one, social class, occupation, appearance, height, weight, skin color, etc. Boy, people got issues, right? Just because they don't look like the way you want them to. Really, mental capacity and any other distinction that might be considered by some as liability. The term covers written as well as oral communication with some forms of behaviors in a public setting. It is also sometimes called antilocution and is the first point of Alport's scale, which measures prejudice in society. In many countries, deliberate use of hate speech is a criminal offense prohibited under incitement to hatred legislation. It is often alleged that the criminalization of hate speech is sometimes used to discourage legitimate discussion of negative aspects of voluntary behavior, such as political persuasion, religious adherence, philosophical allegiance. There's also some question as to whether or not hate speech falls under the protection of freedom of speech in some countries. Both of these classifications have sparked debate with counterarguments such as, but not limited to, a difficulty in distinguishing motive and intent for crimes, as well as philosophical debate on the validity of valuing targeted hatred as a greater crime than general misanthropy and contempt for humanity being a potentially equal crime in and of itself. You guys with me here? We're talking about hate. And to me, hate is a very strong word. How do you feel about that? Aren't you tired of reading that somebody shot somebody, somebody stabbed somebody, somebody did something wrong, somebody hated somebody, somebody talked about somebody, somebody's gossiping about somebody? Aren't you sick of it? I am. Even in families, aren't you tired of always somebody trying to get somebody, trying to manipulate or trying to be vindictive because they did something that you didn't like and now you're going to be, oh, I'm going to get you. You made me angry. I'm going to get you. Why? Why even go there? There's something huge missing in that, isn't it? Some of you know what I'm talking about. If you know my spirit, you know what I'm leading to, right? Those of you who are just tuning in, I want to thank you for joining us. This is WLTH, Sound Off with EVE. And I am emotional today, but it's not me that's emotional. It's the world that's losing its love, respect, empathy for humankind, for human, period. 219-85-1371. Now you know where I'm leading to, right? And before I end this show, I'm going to have you listen to a 5-minute audio. You might think it's boring, but it's real. And those of you that know who I am, yes, I'm bold. Yes, I keep it real. I get to the point. I don't, you know, as I say, cut to the chase, beat around the bush. I don't do none of that. I keep it real. And these are real issues that are going on every single day, every minute that we're breathing and taking a breath. Somebody's dying somewhere out there in this world. Our government can't even control that. That's so sad. Our government is even hurting each other. That's sad. Our government even hires somebody to kill somebody. That's terrible, horrible, ungodly. Our police force can't even handle it. And as I heard earlier, Jeffrey, no, hiring more cops is not the solution. We all need to come together as a community. Remember, come in unity. I went to a wonderful, moving, spiritual play, I Can't Sit Down, and you got the crowd laughing. cracking up. Wow. Cedric, I don't know if you're listening, but you did an awesome show. Those scenes were about reality, about what happens in the hood, what happens in families' lives, what's going on now. And you got people laughing. In one of the scenes, two young girls were shot by their daddy because the mother wouldn't allow her to see them. And he said he was drunk. He said, well, if you won't let me see them, then neither will you. But you know what? That happens for real. That play, I hope, was touching many people's heart, but I heard laughter. And I looked around and I said, oh, my good Lord Jesus, you got to be kidding me. Why are you guys laughing? When this happens for real, you wouldn't like it if it happens to you, if you're one of those that were laughing. There was one lady on crack trying to get her kick or trick, whatever you guys call it. See, I don't do drugs, so I don't know how to use all that. Yeah, get the fix, that too. Whatever it is, you guys know what I'm saying. And they thought it was funny. Yeah, there were some comical parts in it. But not through the whole thing. Wow. Maybe people aren't used to having one of those plays here. I don't know. But shame on them. Is that for real? Those scenes were based on real live people. Cedric, you know I'm there for you. You know I'm going to be there talking to your cast, your crew. Because I saw real life on stage. Even though it wasn't real, meaning they were getting shot, but it was fake. But when you look out the door, that's real. Isn't it? You're listening to Sound Off with E.V.E., and I'm here talking to your heart, talking to your spirit. This is WLTH AM 1370. The calling number is 219-885-1371. Enough is enough. Here's the big part that's missing in the picture here. In the world, okay? Now I'm going to get biblical here. All right? That's what's missing, right? I'm not religious. I'm not holy. I'm far from being holy, and I'm certainly not perfect. And perfection is an unattainable goal, in case you didn't know. But I know what I'm saying. And it's not even me who's saying this. This just came to me. All right? I can't sometimes just plan my shows and say, this is what I'm going to have next week, to report it to management. You can't plan your spirit, can you? Enough is enough. Get with the program, people. Smell the double dose of coffee. That's some strong stuff. It may wake you up, right? Here's the missing part of a lot of people, and I'm not pushing it on anybody. Now, let's talk about it biblically. People, must we? Yes. Both the Old and the New Testaments deal with hatred. Ecclesiastes 3:8 teaches that there is, quote, time to love and time to hate. However, the Old Testament, also known as the Jewish Bible, the Tanakh, also contains condemnations of hatred. For example, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. The New Testament emphasizes that evil intentions can be as serious as evil actions. Thus, John counted hatred as serious as murder. Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer, and you know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in himself. All people are, though, according to the gospel, sinners, and only have to look inside of themselves in order to find sin. Loving good means hating sin and turning from vice. Let those who love thy Lord hate evil. Psalm 97:10. Love, as Aquinas teaches, must be divided into love of good things. The healthy movement of the soul, true to itself, and love of the inappropriate objects, the desire to have to and use what may be bad for the soul. It is popularly assumed that one can hate and love the same person at the same time. But Psalm 139 says there is a kind of perfect hatred, which is consistent with love, and is different from the cruel hatred shown by God's enemies. The Hebrew word describing David's perfect hatred means that it brings a process to completion. In other words, goal-oriented opposition. The ultimate opposition to those who oppose God would be to get them to love God, or failing that, to at least stop them from destroying others. The New Testament describes a similar, if not the same, process to deliver unto Satan for the destruction of the flesh, and that the spirit may be saved. Today's popular characterization of good hatred is to, quote, hate the sin but love the sinner. David's, quote, goal-oriented opposition would add that one, quote, loves the sinner, but by reforming the sinner, or at least neutralizing his sin. This is confirmed by the actions of the man who coined, quote, perfect hatred. It is not recorded that David ever physically punished or fought anybody for merely hating or denying God, but only for acts of aggression. He responded to evil proportionately. He defended himself and his nation from violence. But when people merely turn from God in their hearts without physical violence, he composed psalms. Presumably this with the kind of, quote, hatred in David's mind when he and his son wrote the only five verses in the Old Testament that suggest God hates, or God, quote, yeah, hates, not just the sin but the sinner. Further evidence that even in these verses, what God actually hates is the sin, and that God's, quote, hatred is a love-inspired focus on correcting us, is that the people God is said to hate are identified by their sins, of which we're all at least somewhat guilty, aren't we? No one could have hoped if God's, quote, hatred meant to send us to hell, but the whole Bible's a book of hope for everyone. Leviticus 19:17 provides one illustration of how people's concepts of love and hate today have departed from biblical concepts. The verse says, quote, thy shall not hate, but the rest of the verse explains what the means thy shall rebuke thy brother and not tolerate sin upon him. Today's culture often agrees, calling that, quote, tough love, while contemporary culture and the Bible agree on this notion. There are a conflict over the definition of which behavior deserves admonishment. At the most extreme points of difference, contemporary culture may consider the rebuking endorsed by the Bible to the hatred, especially if the behavior is permissible in secular society. For example, disparaging someone based on their choice of an occupation that the Bible states is sinful could be considered hate speech, which may be treated as a criminal offense. So, criminal offense. That's the punishment part for not thinking and choosing wisely. So, where are we going wrong? Anybody got any answers, any solutions besides prayer? Where are we going wrong? I spoke about hatred in this, or hate in this program. It's 45 minutes after the hour. I spoke to you in different forms. Ways, mentally, physically, psychologically, mentally, neurologically. They've tested that. Psychoanalytical views. I even talked about that. One is too many. Children are killing themselves, are killing their parents. Like, whoa! Really? We can't even get our politicians to get it together. We can't even get our law enforcement to get it together. Now, you know what I'm talking about. I'm not specifically pointing out a one police officer or a one mayor or a councilman. I'm not. I'm speaking in general, guys. Because, see, when I point out something that has to do with a police officer, some of my friends or associates always think I'm being negative. Aw, man, baby, I'm keeping it real. There's no need for anyone to hurt anybody. Like the woman that was crossing the street trying to kill herself, that cop grabbed her and brutally beat her. And of course, something negative was posted. Oh, great timing, huh? Meaning bad timing, because our Gary officer was falling on that day. You know? But it wasn't my intention to do it that way. That's just to wake people up. Crime is happening everywhere. People are getting shot, no matter who you are. Whether you're a police officer, a father, a mother, a sister, an aunt, a grandma, a neighbor, doesn't matter. Killing is killing. It's wrong. Get it together, people. We need to pray. We need to smile. We need to enjoy the little that we may have, because tomorrow is not promised. When you lose your loved one, when you're expecting them to live tomorrow, and you wake up and they're no longer here, then what are you going to do? Is that when you're going to look up and say, why? You better think about that twice, and you better do it now. As I always say, for those of you who follow me on Facebook, life is happening now. Let's make things happen. Let's be positive. Why be all grumpy all doggone day? Really? Come on. Everything is done by choice. And it's just as easy as said and done as it is to do it, then just say it. If you put your mind to it, it'll happen. Remember that law of attraction. Hate attracts hate. What do you expect? What would you want back in return if all you do is hate? We need to start loving our children and raising the red flags immediately. Like this. Yes. Don't wait until someone else takes somebody's life and saying, oh, I wish I could have, would have, should have. Fight the fight, people. Parents, come on. Don't give them up to the government, DCFS, juvie. Come on. These children are reacting to something. And unfortunately, grown folks, they're reacting to something too. Am I talking to you? Are you hearing it? Are you feeling it? That's enough. They say God chose a few among all. Well, come on, people. God's saved people. Or shall I say, God uses, what's the word? I've posted before. God uses saved people to save others. Something like that fact. It's the same meaning, but I just can't think of the exact words. If you know what I mean, call to 1-985-1371. This is real. Yes, that's what this show is about. Keeping it real. Real talk about real issues with real people. I'm real. And you're listening. You're real. And it's happening in your neighborhood. It's happening in your backyard. It's happening across town. Somebody else's state. Somebody else's country. And I'm not one to really like talking about all this bad stuff and reading the news over the radio to you. I like to be positive. So let's turn all that negative. Yeah, I said crap last time. I guess I'll say it again. Let's turn all that crap into positive. Let's watch what our kids are doing. Let's pay attention to every red flag. Why do they keep getting angry all the time? Let me find out. I don't care if they don't like that I'm trying to find out. That's too bad. Give them tough love. Don't buy their love with all this material stuff. I know parents do that. Not all. Well, this one here is certainly not going to do it. You got to earn your keep. But parents, don't make that mistake and buy them all this high technology crap. Because all they're going to do is spend time on it. No more communication. No more talking to you, mom. No more talking to your brother. No more talking to you, grandpa. No more talking to you, friend. No more talking to you, girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, wife. 5 minutes. That's all I'm asking you is to listen to this. We need to get it together. Don't buy love. Give it to them. Our youth are reacting because they're needing it. They're lacking it. Jesus, even grown folks need love too, right? They react to it, too. Some people can't even take rejection. And what do? They kill you. They just hit my van. They just hit my van. That car that just passed right now on the right light. Omar, walk out the door. I'm sorry, this is WLTH. Somebody just passed and hit, side-swiped my van. It was a bluish car. If anybody's driving down Fifth Avenue, going to Fourth Avenue on Broadway, that was a hit and run. And, well, that's pretty messed up. Anyway, see, people just don't give a darn anymore. They just ran into my van just now. They just don't care. People, touch your heart. Families are hurting each other based on lies, based on only what they see and what they hear instead of asking, is this true? Jump to conclusions. Let's assume, let's hurt. Because they hurt me, let me hurt them. Communicate. Talk. These smart devices are too darn smart, and we're getting dumber. We're forgetting to spell. We're forgetting to communicate. We're forgetting to talk to people. We're forgetting how to talk to people.
It's okay.
How to communicate. We're totally forgetting. Now listen to this 5 minutes, okay, guys? It caught my attention, and I said, oh my goodness, this is so true. This is what's happening in our society right now. We're so backwards. This is Sound Off with EVE here on WLTH Radio. The call number is 219-885-1371. It's 53 minutes after the hour. And this is what's happening while we're buying all these smart devices, our tablets, our laptops, our smartphones. They're getting so smart, too smart, that they're disregarding real life. Playing outside. Playing outside with a neighbor riding a bike. Or women sitting outside chatting, talking to each other. Or sitting at a bar having a cocktail, talking to each other. Instead, they're looking down. We're missing the point of what life is all about. Can you get it? Can you feel it? Enough. You got it?
None of them really
listen.
Know me. The problem I have sits in the spaces between looking into their eyes or at a name on a screen. I took a step back and opened my eyes. I looked around and realized that this media we call social is anything but when we open our computers and it's our doors we shut. All this technology we have, it's just an illusion. Community, companionship, a sense of inclusion. Yet when you step away from this device of delusion, you awaken to see a world of confusion. A world where we're slaves to the technology we mastered, where information gets sold by some rich, greedy bastard. A world of self-interest, self-image, self-promotion, where we all share our best bits but leave out the emotion. We're at our most happy with an experience we share, but is it the same if no one is there? Be there for your friends, and they'll be there too, but no one will be if a group message will do. We edit and exaggerate, crave adulation. We pretend not to notice the social isolation. We put our words into order until our lives are glistening. We don't even know if anyone is listening. Being alone isn't a problem. Let me just emphasize, if you read a book, paint a picture, or do some exercise, you're being productive and present, not reserved and recluse. You're being awake and attentive and putting your time to good use. So when you're in public and you start to feel alone, put your hands behind your head, step away from the phone. You don't need to stare at your menu or at your contact list. Just talk to one another. Learn to coexist. I can't stand to hear the silence of a busy commuter train where no one wants to talk through the fear of looking insane. We're becoming unsocial. It no longer satisfies to engage with one another and look into someone's eyes. We're surrounded by children who, since they were born, have watched us living like robots and think it's the norm. It's not very likely you'll make world's greatest dad if you can't entertain a child without using an iPad. When I was a child, I'd never be home. Be out with my friends on our bikes we'd roam. I'd wear holes in my trainers and graze up my knees. We'd build our own clubhouse high up in the trees. Now the park's so quiet it gives me a chill. See no children outside and the swings hanging still. There's no skipping, no hopscotch, no church and no steeple. We're a generation of idiots, smartphones and dumb people. So look up from your phone, shut down the display. Take in your surroundings, make the most of today. Just one real connection is all it can take to show you the difference that being there can make. Be there in the moment as she gives you the look that you remember forever as when love overtook. The time she first holds your hand or first kiss your lips. The time you first disagree but still love her to bits. The time you don't have to tell hundreds of what you've just done because you want to share this moment with just this one. The time you'll sell your computer so you can buy a ring for the girl of your dreams who is now the real thing. The time you want to start a family and the moment when you first hold your little girl and get to fall in love again. The time she keeps you up at night and all you want is rest. And the time you wipe away the tears as your baby flees the nest. the time your baby girl returns with a boy for you to hold, and the time he calls you granddad and makes you feel real old. The time you take in all you've made just by giving life attention, and how you're glad you didn't waste it by looking down at some invention. The time you hold your wife's hand, sit down beside her bed, you tell her that you love her, lay a kiss upon her head. She then whispers to you quietly, as her heart gives a final beat, that she's lucky she got stopped by that lost boy in the street. But none of these times ever happened. You never had any of this. When you're too busy looking down, you don't see the chances you miss. So look up from your phone, shut down those displays. We have a finite existence, a set number of days. Don't waste your life getting caught in the net, as when the end comes, nothing's worse than regret. I'm guilty too of being part of this machine, this digital world we are heard but not seen, where we type as we talk and we read as we chat, where we spend hours together without making eye contact. So don't give in to a life where you follow the hype. Give people your love, don't give them your like. Disconnect from the need to be heard and defined. Go out into the world, leave distractions behind. Look up from your phone, shut down that display. Stop watching this video, live life the real way.
Live life the real way, and life is what you make of it. Don't tell me I made you do this, you made me angry, you made me this, you made me, then that must mean I have a lot of control over you. Life is what you make of it. So make it happen. Make it good. Make it positive. So what if it's storming outside? Who cares? So what if I couldn't pay the bill today? It'll get done. It'll get taken care of. But I'm not going to hurt myself or hate somebody or something because they got it all. But you see, everything happens when it's supposed to. Doesn't happen on your time. It happens on God's time. I lost something it wasn't meant for me to have anyway. That's the attitude you should get. So what? You got all this material stuff, but what you're really missing is in the corazón, in the heart. That's what you may be missing. Love, respect, and more than anything, life. Don't complicate it. Don't hate. Appreciate. And I thank you for listening today. Hope you really, it touched your heart or somebody's. This is Sound Off with E.V.E. here on WLTH Radio. I'll be back tomorrow, God willing, at 6 o'clock. All goes well. And, you know, there's still how many hours left in the day? Quite a bit. You can still do a lot of good things. So sow your seed, make a good deed, do a good deed, rather, every day. And believe me, less complaining, you'll feel even better. With that, I thank you again for joining me here on WLTH Radio, AM 1370, The Region's Choice, The People's Voice. Love you guys. Thank you so much. Be safe out there. The rain came and left, and the sun, or shall I say, the clouds are moving out the way, because here comes the sun. And be that light that you are supposed to be. Be safe, and be careful. Love you.